This is a BIQ Cryo Grip build plate with the Frostbite texture. It's part of BIQ's Panda series of accessories for Bambu Lab printers. It promises some crazy good bed adhesion for PLA and PETG, and I'm going to test it with a couple of challenging prints right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello 3D printing friends and welcome back. Okay, so today we're getting a look at this Cryo Grip flexible build plate for Bambu Lab printers, and thanks to BIQ for sending this over so we could get a look at it. So BIQ makes two versions of Cryo Grip plates. There's this one with the Frostbite texture designed specifically for PLA and PETG, and there's this one with the Glacier texture. It's got a finer, smoother grain to it. And while the Glacier plate works with PLA and PETG, it also works with ABS and nylon and pretty much any material that uses a nozzle temperature under 300 degrees Celsius. If you're not sure about whether a particular type of filament is compatible with a specific Cryo Grip plate, there's a handy filament compatibility chart on the product page. Both plates are double-sided spring steel sheets, and BIQ says they both offer excellent adhesion for filament, with the Frostbite plate being a bit stronger, though again, that one's limited to just PLA and PETG. They've got them for the larger 256mm sized Bambu Lab printers like the A1, P1, and X1 series, as well as for the 180mm sized A1 Mini. The larger ones are about $24 US, while the smaller ones are about $14, and they're linked in the description if you want to check them out. So what's with the cryo in Cryo Grip? Well, when people think about waste in 3D printing, they generally think about filament waste, but there's also energy waste and waste heat from the 3D printing process, and the Cryo Grip plates let you print without a lot of bed heat, or even with none at all. You can run the bed at 30 degrees Celsius instead of 60 and still get amazing results. And 30 degrees Celsius is about 86 degrees Fahrenheit, which is generally just a little bit over room temperature, instead of 60 degrees or 140 degrees Fahrenheit, which is over halfway to the boiling point of water. So not only will your printer use less power, it won't have to wait for the bed to get up to a high temperature, and it can get started printing in less time. Now, about the grip part of Cryo Grip. Sometimes getting parts to stick to your print bed can be difficult. If there's only a small part of the model touching the bed on the first layer, the nozzle can sometimes exert enough force to knock it loose from the bed as the print job goes on. Or perhaps there are a lot of really small parts that need to stick perfectly in order for your print to succeed. Or there may be other issues with the model's geometry that could potentially cause it to pop loose from the bed. For instance, maybe you need to print something diagonally to maximize the build volume of the printer, but you don't want to use supports. So the Cryo Grip build plates, with their special coating, promise to keep your parts stuck to the bed, but release them with a quick flex when the printing is done. The plate I'm testing today is the coarser PLA and PETG only Frostbite one on the Bambu Lab A1. I'm going to print a couple of different things to test bed adhesion. Since it's almost Christmas, I'm going to print some ornaments. These are from designer Zammer3D, and they're on Bambu Lab's MakerWorld site. I've got some generic gold silk PLA loaded in the AMS light on my A1, and I've got the model loaded up in Bambu Studio Slicer. This model is designed to print in spiral vase mode, which means the printer only prints the outer wall of it, and it does it by slowly and constantly moving the Z-axis up. The nozzle moves in a spiral path, kind of like a slinky toy, instead of printing one layer and then moving up in a quick jump to the next layer and so on. Here's an excellent example of how that looks. The filament here wasn't sticking well to itself. This one broke, and you can easily see the spiral aspect of spiral vase mode. So anyway, back to the model. It has a very small amount of contact with the build plate, just that initial circle you see here in orange. To help with bed adhesion, Bambu Studio wants to automatically add a brim to give the model a much larger contact area with the bed, and that's the blue part. But I'm going to turn that off because I want to see if the Cryo Grip plate is going to hold on to this one little circle of filament and keep the entire ornament in place during this print job. I've told Bambu Studio that I'm printing on a cool plate, and it's got the correct cool plate AR code on it for the Bambu Lab printers that read those. So I'll send that to the printer. Here's a quick time lapse of the print. And here it is, finished. This stuck amazingly well for just having a thin circle of filament touching the bed. I'm going to try that again with some magenta silk PLA, printing the other ornament in this pack. This one's a little bit more complicated than the first one, with lots of back and forth motion. But the Cryo Grip held it just as well as it held the first one. And then last, I wanted to do the print a long thin part at an angle and see if it holds on kind of print. So I added a cube to the build plate and scaled it so it was 15 millimeters by 15 millimeters by about 400 millimeters tall. Now, the reason I made it so much taller than the A1 can print is because I planned to set it at a 45 degree angle. But I didn't just angle it on the x-axis or the y-axis, I angled it on both the x and y-axes to get the maximum size I can possibly get. I pushed it down through the build plate until it just cleared the top of the build volume. Then I cut off the part that stuck out below the build plate. Then I sliced it and sent it to the printer, and I wanted the printer to take a time lapse of it. So here's that time lapse. And it almost made it. The thing I failed to account for was that the printer's time-lapse feature moves the tool head out of the way to take a frame for the video, and then moves it back to the model to continue printing. As a result, the nozzle eventually knocked the print off the bed at about 80% done. So I printed it without the time-lapse turned on, and this time it completed successfully. There are a couple of little issues where the model itself flexed while being nudged slightly by the nozzle, but it did not actually break free from the Cryo Grip plate. The final length of this part is 360 millimeters. Not bad for a printer with a build volume of 256 millimeters per axis, right? Now, I wouldn't normally print something this tall and skinny at such an angle without supports, but I wanted to see how the Cryo Grip plate would handle it. And it did a great job. I'm pretty impressed. Okay, now I know somebody would get upset if I didn't also test with PETG, so I printed a third base mode ornament to see how it would do. And surprise, it also stuck great on the Frostbite Cryo Grip, and it popped loose when I flexed the plate. I love it when things stick like they're supposed to, but come off when you want them to. So does the Frostbite plate have any special care and feeding instructions? Actually, yes. The only thing you should clean it with is soap and water. Dish soap and warm water work really well. Do not use alcohol on this plate. Alcohol will destroy its future and ruin its life. Probably don't use other solvents either, so no acetone or anything else. Just plain old dish soap and water. It's got an oleophobic coating on it, so it's supposed to resist the occasional bit of oil from your fingers without much fuss, but as with any build plate, you should probably avoid too much finger contact. And I wouldn't recommend using it to keep a slice of pepperoni pizza warm and then starting a print without washing the plate first. So that's the BIQ Cryo Grip double-sided flex plate with the Frostbite textured surface for printing PLA and PETG on Bambu Lab printers. Thanks again to BIQ for sending this over, and big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool. Literally. Not only will your printer use less power, it won't have to wait for the bed to get up to a high temperature, and it can start getting printed in less. Getting printed?